Naufrage was mainly composed by arranging and specializing heavily processed sounds originated from two-channel recording sessions. An indoor recording session was carried out inside the studio where interactions with different objects such as rocks, glassware recipients and the glockenspiel were recorded, as well as an outdoor recording session on the shores of Whitehead, a town near Belfast from where most of the water-based sounds and textures come from. After recording, I started working on the piece inside the Sonic Lab, an offering and flexible concert venue based at Sark, Belfast, which offers composers the possibility to surround the audience by more than 48 loudspeakers across length, width and height. The piece was originally designed for 32 speakers by employing 4 octophonic rings displaced along the vertical axis, where the first layer is under the audience, the second at ground level, while the third and fourth correspond to first and second floor above the listener's head. From the very first days of working inside the Sonic Lab, I decided that I wanted to achieve 3 spatial effects: envelopment for conveying the feeling of being immersed inside a cave, localization for distinguishing a well-defined static location in space for certain sounds, and motion to perceive other sounds as jumping or moving through space, following linear or circular or diagonal trajectories. However, although the desired spatial discourse determined much of the musical decisions, the overall structure was also influenced by the metaphors of the 4 sections. Being so important to the concept, the sections and their climaxes determined the evolution of the composition. The first musical ideas of Naufrage started to develop while experimenting with a range of sound design techniques in MaxMSP and Reaper, including granular synthesis, gating, comp filtering, pitch shifting and modulating various sound parameters applied over certain elements of the recordings. Based on this, new sounds were created and grouped into different categories which were technically suitable for either one of the envelopment, localization or motion effects based on their spectromorphology. I proceeded with accentuating similarities or contrast between these sounds and layering them until certain themes or motifs would emerge, which this time needed to be aesthetically suitable for conveying the states of confusion, deliberation, acceptance and struggle. A particular group of sounds that are highlighted in the piece are the water sounds, which aid in creating localization: wave smashing, flowing streams from spring or faucet, etc. I discovered that by brutally noise gating them, I obtained dried, short bursts which sounded really interesting when sent to different speakers of the upper layers, while adding multi-channel reverb coming from the underground layer. This proved to be effective both for localization but also for envelopment by creating the perception of a surreal cave with a massive hole under the audience where they could risk falling into. Apart from the water drips that appear sporadically from the 16 speakers of the upper layers, I also used rock sounds in the same fashion. For envelopment, I mostly relied on granular synthesis through which I created sustaining textures. As an example, I was able to prolong the rather short sustaining notes of the glockenspiel while also adding additional harmonics and spreading them on different speakers, resulting in enveloping pitched textures. A similar spatial approach was used for the wind texture, which was completely synthesized by filtering 8 instances of white noise with variable narrow notches and assigning them to each speaker of the ground level octophonic ring. Also, through granular synthesis, additional short duration recordings were transformed into surreal drone textures that also conveyed a certain sense of envelopment when decorrelated and assigned to multiple speakers. However, other sounds assigned to only 1 or 2 speakers also helped by relying on the psychoacoustic effect that we tend to perceive familiar sounds as they would naturally occur. I tried achieving motion through amplitude panning of sound sources across speakers. As an example stand the sounds of sea waves which are being panned back and forth in the underground ring of speakers in such manner as to start from the front, gradually moving towards the center back, coinciding with the shore smashes as if the audience were located just on the edge. Another example are the whispery textures, which are in fact granular synthesis artifacts of rock scraping sounds present in the first sections. These were panned in a semicircular manner in the frontal plane at ear level. Although initially I wanted to do a full 360 movement, I decided to only use the front half of the ring of speakers because I did not want to draw too much attention, defocusing the audience and putting them in a state of technical listening. Other sounds were also panned in the lateral planes as well as in the vertical plane with much caution since trajectories don't translate that well in being amplitude panned vertically. Since there aren't too many rooms available with 32 loudspeakers such as the Sonic Lab in Belfast or the Ligeti Hall in Graz, I experimented with some stereo renditions soon after the piece was finished. This resulted in two stereo versions, one being a recording of the piece inside the Sonic Lab on all speakers using a dummy head microphone, and a stereo mixdown rendered inside Reaper. Although much of the special impression was lost, the dummy head version tries to translate the piece in binaural listening on headphones, while the stereo mixdown is meant for loudspeakers.